It's time for Ben Roethlisberger to be the leader of the Steelers. He has to be the unquestioned leader. And what I mean by leader is he cannot finger point. He cannot deflect blame. He cannot call out teammates. That has to be over and done with. Definitely he should not do that publicly. Maybe he can offer some constructive criticism privately, maybe in practice, that's okay. But calling teammates out publicly, calling coaches out publicly, that has to be over and done with. Because things like that could disrupt the team. Last season, he was doing a lot of that and it hurt the team. I believe that's part of the reason why they did not make the playoffs. Now, I'm not gonna put all the blame on Ben. I think AB, Antonio Brown, he deserves some of the blame. I think Mike Tomlin deserves the blame as well for allowing all this to happen and fester. So he is the leader. By he, I mean Ben Roethlisberger. He has to lead them by playing well, by giving positive feedback, and not calling out teammates. And I believe he's taking steps to do that. Recently, he went on NBC. He interviewed with the lady. I believe her name is Michelle Tafoya. And he did say he regretted calling out AB publicly. So I'm glad he did that. He did apologize for that. Hopefully, he won't call out any more of his teammates. Because not everyone responds to that. So he needs to understand that he is the leader. And it's his job to play well and to help his teammates out by giving feedback and advice. And he's a veteran too. So he's a veteran. He's been around the organization for a while. So these younger players do look up to him. He has to lead by example. And I believe the Steelers will make the playoffs. They have the right team. They would have made it last year if it wasn't for all this turmoil with Antonio Brown, with his antics, not showing up to practice and throwing tantrums. If it wasn't for that, if it wasn't for Ben calling out teammates, if Le'Veon Bell would have gotten paid, and that wouldn't have been a distraction too. So there are a lot of reasons why they did not make the playoffs. I mean, they had a 9-6-1 record. That is unacceptable. A team that was loaded with talent, like the Steelers, teams like that should never miss the playoffs. There's no reason why the Steelers should have missed the playoffs last season. Now, the good thing is, this season hasn't happened yet. So I'm hoping that Ben can lead them to the playoffs, which I believe will happen. I mean, even though they lost AB, even though they lost Le'Veon Bell, they still have a nice roster intact. They've got James Conner, they've got James Washington, they've got JuJu Smith-Schuster, they've got Vance McDonald. So they've got a nice nucleus on the offensive end. And that defense is looking really great in the preseason. They're definitely coming along great. Wow, I'm looking at that rookie, Devin Bush. He jumps off the screen. He is a dynamic player. He definitely will help that Steelers defense tremendously. Hopefully, Sagier will be able to come back. We'll see about that. But that defense is looking great. So they've got a nice offense. They've got a nice defense. Now, everyone has to come together and have to play together. Football is the ultimate team sport. It just is. Everyone has to play together. That's how teams win. Look at the Patriots. Look at all these other teams that are successful. When the team comes together, when distractions are minimized or non-existent, then what you have is a great team that can make the playoffs. And the Steelers can do that. I wouldn't be surprised if they made it to the championship game, if they made it to the AFC championship, or even the Super Bowl. They are that loaded. They are that gifted. But what hurts them is the distractions, is the drama. That's what is weighing this team down. It's like an anchor around them. So, like I said, Ben is the leader. He has to lead by example. And I'm glad that he's no longer doing that radio show. Because sometimes when these athletes get on these radio shows, they try to be too honest. And that's not always a good thing. Sometimes they bash teammates and throw coaches under the bus. And they say things that are better said privately amongst teammates within the football team. Stuff like that should not be aired out publicly, because oftentimes it does more harm than good. So I'm glad he's not doing that radio show anymore, and I hope he just focuses on football, and great things are going to happen for the Steelers this season. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not done so already. just press that subscribe button below this video. If you did that, I would greatly appreciate it. And also, click on the notification bell too. That way, when I put out new content, you won't miss out on any of it. Thanks again for watching. Thanks for listening. I hope that all of you have a blessed, wonderful day.